a new video from Colored and Confetti. Today's video, I will be talking about how I got started running. I wanted to make this video because me personally, I have a huge passion for running. It's probably the most favorite thing that I do, and I just wanted to be able to share what has worked for me and just tips that kind of can get you into creating a lifelong habit. So for me, I began running cross country in middle school, not really knowing what distance running was. I walked into it blindly and it was painful at first. I had no idea about nutrition or hydration, so at first it was very rough. However, my 13-year-old self persisted and I was able to keep going, and it became something that I really enjoyed and I just grew to really love going on runs. I stopped running when I was pregnant with my first son. With that being said, I gained an obscene amount of weight. I gained around 65, 70 pounds, give or take, and it made running wasn't an option. After my son was about a year and a half old, I kind of still was carrying a few extra pounds, and that's when it kind of occurred to me, do what you enjoy, do things that you love, and that's when I decided I'm gonna start running again. I mulled that idea for around, however, I was a stay-at-home mom, so I knew that if I was going to do any type of exercise that I was also going to have to involve my baby. So that's when I, you know, started shopping around for jogging strollers, and that's kind of what was the first thing. I purchased a really good jogging stroller so that I really had no excuse. Some things that worked for me in the beginning was looking on Pinterest. There is a whole thing you can type in for running motivation, and it'll show you things that really motivate you. Like, you know, there will be a day when you can no longer run. Today is not that day. Just little things to kind of help, you know, if you're not feeling motivated, they can motivate you because you will feel like, hey, I want to go and, you know, use my legs that I have and go outside and run because I actually can. There are some people that cannot. Having not had run for a while, it is painful. Every runner that, you know, has periods where they stop running and then they pick it up again, it is painful. It's just important to know that you keep at it, and it will become easier, and then it just becomes something that is part of who you are. You are a runner the same way that you breathe oxygen. The more you keep at it, you will get to a point of where it doesn't feel like work and it's something that you look forward to. Your day can't really, you know, it isn't really the same until you get your run in. You don't look at it as exercise, you don't look at it as work, you look at it as something that you get to do and you feel better for it. Everybody says the same thing. Start with something, you know, attainable. Start with, if you can't run a mile, start with a quarter of a mile. Once you work to a quarter of a mile, go to a half a mile, and obviously so on and so on. The most important thing for me to, you know, advice to give is that it's 100% in your mind. If you're a healthy individual, meaning you don't have any injuries or underlying conditions like asthma or, you know, there's a whole bunch of things, but if you're in general good health, you just have to keep at it, and 100% it's in your mind. Just telling yourself not to listen to your body, but listening to your mind, knowing that you can actually do it. I just think that it's really important that, you know, you just kind of, a lot of times people don't want to go to that uncomfortable position. They kind of like being, you know, comfortable. They don't want to go to pain, and you just kind of had to accept that in the beginning, that that's where you know, if you are a runner, if you enjoy exercise, in that moment, you're going to live in pain. Everybody, even experienced athletes, you live in the pain and just being okay with being in that pain threshold. It will be painful at times when you first start, and just kind of owning it. You know, people are so, they get in their own head. That's something that I also struggled with. You know, I was 65 pounds heavier, or I felt like, you know, I was running too slow. Just knowing that you're getting 1% better every day, even if, you know, it's nothing huge, it's still an improvement to what you were doing yesterday, and that's really important, rather than just sitting around and wishing something were different, but actually putting things in place to actually make it happen. Running has so many benefits that I just think it's really important. I have completed marathon and half marathon, and those are some of the hardest things that I've ever done. Literally, the hardest things I've ever done. there were times when I was running my marathon where I just felt like I cannot do, you know, take one more step. However, like I said, it is 100% mental, and just keep telling yourself, just put one foot in front of the other and you will get through it. Don't think about how much more you have to go. Think about just setting one foot in front of the other and you can do it. You will want to quit. Your body, it will hurt. Everything will start to hurt. It's just kind of tricking your brain into not focusing on the pain and thinking, you know, find your happy place. It's also very important to have things that motivate you. A good pair of shoes or a cute running outfit is really helpful, because at first you're not going to want to do it, and maybe the first time you do it you are sore the next day, so it's going to be hard to kind of keep doing something. But if you have, you know, a cute outfit or a cute pair of running shoes, that really helps to kind of, you know, give you incentive to go out and do it. Something that was also really helpful for me, I purchased a running watch. This is the Garmin Forerunner 235, and I'm a visual person, so I really needed to see my progress in action. It also has mobile capabilities, so I could check my progress on my phone. It showed me how fast I was running, my pace. It also showed me distance. There's a lot of other cool specs on there, like heart rate, GPS, different things, but I really, you know, found that useful to see that I was running 10 miles a week, or, you know, to kind of bump it up, and kind of allows you to set little goals that kind of push you to do a little bit more, or to make sure you're maintaining that progress. Another thing that really is useful, I have to run with music, so I purchased these Beats. I think they're like the Beats Pro or Power Beats Pro. They're really awesome. I've always had Beats. They just, you know, I have to run with music. Some people like to, you know, listen to nature. Me personally, that's where I can really zone out on my song that I'm listening to, and kind of, it's like a temporary escape from what I'm actually doing, and I can just focus on the music and not that, you know, maybe I'm in a little bit of pain. Something that's also super important, I live on the East Coast where it gets very, very humid, so something for hydration is very important. This one is from Camelback, and it's just for those long runs. That way you can have, you know, water with you on the go. Very easy, but it's just very important. You know, you want to keep hydrated while you're running, because you are sweating so much. Hopefully I have shared some things with you that are useful. Running is free, so even right now with everything closed, you know, you don't have to go to a gym. You don't need fancy equipment. All you need is, you know, a good pair of shoes. You don't have to have everything. It's just, you know, something that you can start now, and you probably will end up creating a lifelong habit if you just, you know, keep at it. Hopefully you found the tips that I provided useful. Running is something that people usually love it or hate it. However, I feel like people don't really give it enough of a chance. You know, we were forced to do things like running the mile in high school, so that kind of taints people's view. However, it's very beneficial not only for your body, but also your mind. And running is free. You don't need a lot of fancy equipment. You don't need to go to the gym. You can include your kids. It's just so many benefits, and also what it will do to your mind. Running is difficult. Running can be very hard. However, I think it is 100% mental, and that will kind of translate into other areas of your life. You know that you can do anything because you've completed a run where you told yourself, I can't do this, I can't do this, but you showed up and you proved that you could do it. If you like these topics, you can visit my blog, which will be linked in the description. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Have a nice day!